Okay, so today I'm going to start with some basics of supervised learning. This is actually not online learning, but supervised learning, that just as a precursor to our online learning. Okay, so we will try to map what we are going to do in supervised learning in the offline setting, how the kind of metrics, the kind of algorithms, the kind of strategy we are going to see, whether we will have a natural mapping when we move to the online learning settings. So, fine, let us do the revisit our basic things that we would have done in the supervised learning methods. As I said in the beginning, this course is about learning setups, learning different learning setups, looking for the best algorithms. When I say best, if I am saying something is best, I need to show it, like this is the best. So how one is going to show something is best? That you have to say that you can't do better than this. Okay. So our focus of this course will be like coming up with algorithm and then showing their best through giving a detailed analysis. Because of that, as we grow on this, as we go into this course, we will get into a lot of analysis. So you have to be like bit focused. Sometimes the proofs and all can get dry. So if you lose track, then you will be totally lost for the rest of the class. So interrupt me at any point if you are not following anything. So it's not necessary that you have to cover all the proofs, but till whatever steps we are going to cover in the group, it's important that we are all in sync with that. Okay, so what is our supervised learning method? What we have? So basically, supervised thing is you have, let's take the simplest case of classification. Further simplest case, that is a binary classification. You have given an instance, you have to say whether it has a label 0 or 1. So let's try to set up this simple thing in a bit more formal way. So for this, what all the things we know? First thing, we are going to start with, we are going to assign a label to something, right? What is that we are going to assign a label? We are going to assign a label to, let's say, some instance. To be concrete, let's take some example. Let's say you are a stock enthusiast and you want to predict your stock is going to go up or down. Okay, your share value is going to up or down. Then if I give you a stock, that stock is what you are basically predicting the label, right? You are basically, so that we are going to call the point, the set from which these stocks are coming, we are going to, let's say, we are going to call it as some domain set. And we are going to denote it by x. And this is set of objects. That we wish to label. So in our stock example, this script x could be a collection of stocks to which I want to say whether we want to label whether their share price are going to go up or down. Another example could be, let's say you have some information about the weather, let's say you know let us say weather information has only two things, like how humid it is and how, what is the temperature. If I tell you this information, you have to predict whether it is going to rain or not. Your job is to say whether it is going to rain or not. In that case, this x is what? In this case, the x could be collection of all these pairs. The pairs is like humidity value and the temperature value. Okay. So, in this case, this x could be subset of R2. So, you give me any point in this, that means somebody told, okay, today this is the humidity level and this is the temperature, and you would like to tell whether it is going to rain or not. And second thing is label set, but the label set we have already fixing, we have kind of already restricting ourselves to binary labels, but labels could be any number of labels. So, this could be like, let us say, set of outcomes. And I am going to denote it by a script y. And in the binary case, this guy can be simply 0, 1. Or it could be also, I can equivalently take it as plus 1 and minus 1. And now, the one who is going to give labels based on the input you give from this domain set, let us call him a learner. So, learner is basically trying to do what? He is coming up with a rule that will tell if this is the input, this should be the output. And he may have access to multiple rules, right? If you give me weather, that let us say humidity and the temperature value, I may combine them in some various ways to come up with the output that is saying, okay, whether it is going to rain or not. So, I have multiple possible rules, right? And the learner may have access to finite set of rules, and he may want to pick one from that to give you the outcome. So, we are going to that set of rules that is accessible to the learner, we are going to call it as hypothesis class. And we are going to denote it as H. And this H is nothing but a collection of rules which are maps from Y to So, all of you understand this notation? These are all functions which maps your input to some label in set Y. Okay, there could be multiple such hypotheses, so that is why I am going to denote it as a set. This set is collection of these rules. Now, the learner here, he has to find which is the rule is the best, or like he have to basically, let us say for time being, he has to pick one rule from this. So, how he is going to decide? He is going to possibly decide based on the past observations or the past history. For example, he might have from historical data from weather department, you would have seen that with this temperature, with this humidity, this happened, rain happened or not. So, he may have all the data observed from past, and he is going to use that to see which rule or which hypothesis he likes to pick. Okay, so, the learner has access to training data. We are going to call it as training data. And that is we are going to call it, that is S, and this S will have where we are going to say xi belongs to thread for all I to m and yi belongs. So, there are m points, we are going to call this training data, there are m points in the training data. Each point here is a pair. The first part denotes the object here that is coming from my set X, that is my domain set, and the second component is the label that is coming from my label set. Okay. So, we have these components in this, the learner is have access to this training data, he has access to this hypothesis class, and now he has to figure out which is the best hypothesis for him that does a good job of prediction on a given data point. Okay. So, when I say data point, it will be, it can mean two things. Data point could be, it will have this object as well as associated label. Sometimes data point I mean to say only the first part, it may not have the associated label, and in that case you have to come up with the label. Okay. So, you will either say simply data point or a sample. When I say sample, if we do not have label for it, our job is to predict it, and once we have already have it, that is part of our training data. Okay. Now, when I said the learner's objective is to pick an hypothesis from this that in some way does a good job, right, on the prediction task. Okay. So, let us try to quantify that, like what is that the learner's objective would be. So, we are going to say here learning for the learner is pick an hypothesis from this class which is good in some sense, that we will make it clear in what sense. Okay. So, now learning boils down to learning this hypothesis. I want to identify which is a good hypothesis from this class which is given to me. Okay, now let us say, now I am learning on a data set, right? But then the question is, how is this data set looks like or how it gets generated, right? Is this data is arbitrary? Like if I ask you somebody to give me data, like can he just generate data and give it to me? Anything will do. We are going to assume that there is an underlying process that is going to generate this data. Okay. And actually that process is known to me, and my job is to kind of figure out that underlying process that is generating data. Okay. So, for just our beginning, we are going to assume a simple data generation model. We are going to assume that data is generated according to some distribution D. We said that the data points are coming from this domain set and how they are picked. They are picked according to this distribution D. So, is this clear to you? Okay, let us say I have said I have a training data, right? This training data, when I said, how are these points generated in this? Each of these points, I have told you they belong to this, but when you generate this point, it is going to be sampled from this set according to this distribution D. Okay? So, we are in this case, we are going to say that xi is according to this distribution D. So, this is about the first part of this data point, how these samples are generated. Okay? Also, this first part of this data point, they are also called features. Okay? And so, henceforth we start calling them as features, and we are going to call this as domain set as also a feature set. Okay? So, for example, in the rain prediction problem, we said the humidity level and the temperature level, right? This could just act as a feature for us. Okay? So, given a feature, I want to identify whether it is going to rain or not. That is, I want to assign a label. And these features are generated according to this distribution D. We are going to say that this distribution D is fixed throughout. It is not going to change, but I do not know it. Okay? What I get to see is the samples generated from this distribution D. Okay, this is one part of this data set, right? I told you how to generate the features. And we are going to say that there is a label function f which will make it yi equals to f of x. Again, I am assuming that this, once you tell me a feature, the associated label is governed by this function f, and we will assume again for simplicity, for just in the beginning, that these f's are again fixed, but I do not know them. Okay? So, how these features are generated and how the labels are generated, both I do not know, but they are fixed. Now, and we are going to usually say that this is the environment. Okay? The D together with F, this constitute for us environment. Both of this I do not know, but the data generation is governed by this environment. Okay. So, now we are going to how you are going to do a measure, how you are going to say that. So, we said our goal is to pick a good hypothesis from this hypothesis class, right? Then we need to quantify what is that good we are talking about. So, that is the measure of success. So, the measure of success we are going to use is called, if you let us say give me hypothesis H from this hypothesis class, I am going to say its success is probability that H of x is not equals to f of x, given that so what does this tell? the probability that your hypothesis does not give the same label as the underlying label generating function f, right? And notice that I am taking this probability with respect to this distribution d, okay? So now this x is generated according to this distribution, but this is kind of any x it is, it could be any x here, right? So whereas when I did this training that these are the some specific data points which has been sampled from distribution D and that is made available to me. When you are trying to measure the success of the hypothesis you came, I am going to look at all x's, entire x, but I will be looking at by sampling them according to the distribution and look over this. Okay, so what we are basically do is whatever the training set that is given to me, I am going to use this, let us say I will come up with some hypothesis and I want to measure the success of that hypothesis. I am going to see how good it performed on a random x that I picked from some distribution D. So when I pick a x randomly from this disk, that could act as my test point and these points are all my training points. So let us make this bit more formal. So if I have defined my measure of success like this for a hypothesis h, what kind of h you would like to use? So let us say you are a learner and I am like a, so you have access to the hypothesis class. And let us say I am a measurer, like I am going to evaluate your performance and my evaluation performance criteria is this. What kind of h you would like to give me? The one minimizes this quantity, right? And we are going to call this guy as here. So this is like prediction error, or maybe I can also call test error. As a learner, you would like to find an hypothesis which has the smallest test error, right? So my goal could be minimize the hypothesis class H. Okay. Right now, let us say we have not made any assumption that whether this hypothesis class is finite or infinite, countable infinite or uncountable anything, but let us be a bit vague here and still write minimum of this quantity here. Okay, fine. So is this entire setup is clear now? What we usually try to do in the supervised learning case, like under the simplified case, like binary classification and everything. Okay, so maybe let's, why not just write it, x is a random variable. You understand probability with respect to random variable, right? This x is a random variable here and that x has distribution D, that's what I mean. Okay. So even though I have written this x1, x2 as small quantities, but these are like x when I draw, right? So maybe I should just write it here. This x, the feature vector is a random quantity that I am going to sample according to distribution D. I am not sampling, like somebody has sampled and given it to you, and from that you have now got the realizations and then you are trying to do. So think this setup like this. So let us say nature has its own rule, mother nature, it relates whether the rain happens or not to humidity and temperature in some fashion. It follows its own laws, we do not know about those laws. But we have observed this, like maybe like for the past 50 years or something, we have been observing what is happening. When the humidity level was this temperature, so that let us say somebody has recorded this information. So, whatever the nature's law it has been using, we have seen the samples of this over the last 50 years. Okay? And that law is this, that is the environment. It is generating these features and the associated labels according to this distribution, which we do not know. But what we are interested is, suppose if I just get to observe humidity and wind and the temperature level, will I be able to predict my rain the way the nature would have done it, or the way it would have happened in reality? That is the goal here. That is what I am trying. So, this is like it always happens that you will see the feature vector, and at the end the you can think of label as the result. So, in this case whether rain happened or not is the label, right, that you are going to see the result. So, let us say you saw both temperature and the humidity growing in some fashion, and at the end of this, as a result of these two, the rain is going to happen or not. So, that is like an outcome, right, like rain happened or not, and that depends on these two value. You have observed, let us say humidity and temperature, and now you want to kind of predict whether it is going to happen or not. And also like in the stock market case, right, like you want to see tomorrow my stock price is going to, share price is going to go up or not. From your, so market has its own dynamics. A market laws are governed, maybe very complicated, you do not know it. So, based on that, you have past historical data from the stock exchange, you have observed that based on this, like if this has happened, like let us say whatever the feature vectors, if this has happened, the next day the share price went up or not. So, you have that past observation, and now let us say today something happened, like you have observed the current market scenario, and now you want to predict whether tomorrow your share price are going to go up or not. So, that is what we are trying to do. So, this is based on the samples generated by the underlying environment, which I do not know. And now, I want to see that if any features are generated on this, how good my predictions are. H of x is what is basically prediction or the label assigning, right? How good I am assigning a label that is as good as the nature would have assigned it. If I can do this, so suppose I find a hedge such that this guy, this probability is very, very small. If this guy, this probability is very, very small, that whatever the feature vector, I am able to make the correct prediction of its label or its outcome, right? That means in a sense, I have figured out what nature is doing. That means I have learnt these things from my observations. Okay. Now, the next question is, fine, you have set up the problem, you have set up your learning environment, you have set up your measure of success, how you go about achieving, how you are going to get a hypothesis from your observed data. Okay. So, all you have this, somebody generated a data and gave it to you, they have been also, you let us say learner has said, okay, I am going to use this much hypothesis. Now, this is your objective, how you are going to go about it. So, basically I want to find a hypothesis that kind of minimizes this quantity, right? Okay, suppose for time being, pretend that you happen to be the god, or you happen to be the nature, or you happen to the oracle, or God revealed you what is the distribution he is going to use to generate this feature vectors, and he also told you what is the labels function that he is using to assign labels to the feature. So, I am saying God told you these two things, then what we would have done? In that case, for any h, can you compute this? If you know the distribution, if you know your function, for any h you can compute this, right? Then it simply boils down to minimizing this. But God, why should God tell me, right? I do not know this. What I have been like, but what I have been doing is I am observing what like oracular God is doing, and now I am trying to imitate him, right? So how best you can imitate him? So you have access to only this. Okay, so from this you have to come up with something. So how will you do this?